So, Higher Ground. It's a lifetime's worth of education in funk. With Stevie, I think there's this difference in that because he played all of the parts, it's entirely his own rhythm, you know? And I don't think anybody can nail that. So what I'm constantly disappointed by when I hear people interpreting Higher Ground live, particularly focusing on the guitarists, is this tendency to emphasize the flat third and the fifth. What I mean by that is if we're starting in E flat, the flat third being the G chord and the fifth being the A. So the change there. I think when everybody emphasizes that, it draws the attention too far there. So the two guitar parts that I studied come from Stevie Wonder's Live at Last. The guitarists on there are Kyle Bolden and Errol Cooney, I believe. And one of them is playing a sort of shuffle rhythm on the chords, and the other one is outlining the chord voicings. So I'm going to go over both and talk a little bit about either, noting that in what I just played, I kind of switched between the two. So to start with, the shuffle rhythm. An important thing to note here is that I am playing with my guitar tuned to E-flat. You know, Stevie Wonder plays the black keys, so I'm like, I'm going to do the same. It feels like the funkiest chord. So we're playing an E-flat 7 sharp 9, the Hendrix chord. That means we're going to be playing a G, a D-flat, and an F-sharp. I'm not playing the root, which is the E, because the bass is playing that. So it's that classic thing, which I think is important in funk guitar, where we're picking the notes we're playing, and we're staying out of the way of the other instruments harmonically. So to start with, that's our first chord. I'm going to talk now about the rhythm. I'm not entirely sure around the theory. I'm feeling it effectively like a shuffle. So what I mean by that is, my hand is moving constantly, so I don't stop after the upstroke. So I'll do it slow. So that's the first thing. I would just sit on that E flat 7 sharp 9 and practice that rhythm slowly at first, and then maybe move up your speed. The other thing to think there though is that if you're not good at palm muting, it's very easy for that to be messy and get in the way. So you could potentially just go, which is just a Motown chant chord. Effectively, that's what's going on there. Just playing the 2 and the 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. That's the simplest solution. But it is really fun to play this and to lean into the shuffle. So at tempo, when I'm playing in the context of a full band and not wanting to get into the way, I will be reducing the amount of volume on the palm mute. So, my hand continues to move because for me that's really important for my sense of rhythm, and I'm removing as many palm mutations. The second thing to think about there is we're moving up between that flat third chord and the 5 chord, which is basically we're just doing a G triad with a G on top and an A triad on top, okay? F sharp, B flat, D flat, F sharp, and then A flat, C, E flat, A flat. So this is where it's kind of slightly more complicated because we're feeling the shuffle. So we're playing the G very briefly as almost a passing chord before we get to the A. The key there is that shuffle rhythm, you know? The shapes themselves aren't too complicated. It's the feeling that takes a while to get. So that's the first part of the groove. The second time around, we're going to outline that little change. So with that line, we're starting on a D flat, B flat, A, A flat, F sharp. And it's kind of a pull off. First part of the groove. Second part gets a little more complicated. So initially all we're doing is taking that change or that series of chords and we're moving it up a tone. So we're going to F. So I'm playing a F7 sharp 9 and we're just going through F7 sharp 9, A flat, B flat. Okay, we do that once. Then the changes here are where we get a little bit funky, okay? So to start with, we're playing a F7 flat 5 suspended. So I'll start from down here. We're playing a F in the bass, a B, an E flat, and then an F. And then we're moving that up a tone. Yeah? Easy peasy. So then we're going to play a, I guess it would be a A flat 9. So I'm playing that as a, what might consider to be my 7 shape, A7, A flat 7. And then I'm adding the 9th at the top, which is a B flat. And then we're ending it off by going to a D7. D flat, I'm playing a D flat 7. Without the D in the bass. So to put that all together, yeah. So I'm just cutting in here because I got this part wrong the first time I recorded this video. So, what we're going to be doing for this third section of Higher Ground is initially we're going to be playing between the 4 and the 1 in the key of E flat. So that means we're playing A flat 7 and E flat 7. The rhythm is the same as the first part. We're just gonna be playing these nice little triads, starting on an E flat, a G flat, and a C. Sometimes I like to play a sus, an A flat 7 sus, which means I'm just playing a C sharp instead of the C. It's very Princey. Okay, so we'll start with that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Then we're gonna go to an E flat 7. For that, I'm playing a D flat, a G, and a B flat. Okay? You can kind of play an E, whatever E7 shape you're used to playing on the top three or four strings. You could play that, you could play that, you can play that, you can play a ninth even, so playing the F, or you can play that, or you can play that. So 1, 2, 3, 4, A flat 7, E flat 7. We do this 3 times, and then we're going to go to F7. Yeah, so for the F7, it's the same shape that you played for the E flat 7. We're just moving it up a tone. In this case, we'll be playing an E flat, a B, and a C. 2, 3, 4, and then we go to a 5 chord. And then this is the funky chord. We're starting on the 7 A flats. D, F sharp. F sharp, and a C sharp. So kind of like an augmented chord with a sharp 9. Except instead of playing the root, playing an A. And we're just doing... And that's it. Then we're back to the form. So we're now going to play the little, like, dotted rhythm kind of part that is played by the second guitarist. E flat, A flat, E flat, Jeff flat, G flat. Yeah? Then we're gonna play B flat, D flat, C, E flat. Then we're going to kind of like call and response, play a similar riff, but starting on the B flat up the octave. So B flat, E flat, B flat, D flat. And then what we're going to do is we're going to play that little riff. So that is D flat, B flat, A, A flat, G flat. Okay, all together. Then we're taking our first riff and we're playing it in F instead of E flat. F, B flat, F, A flat. Then we're going to play C, E flat, D, E flat. One more time. And then we're going to outline F7 flat 5 sus, G7 flat 5 sus, and G flat 9. So we're starting up here on a F, B, E flat, another F. We're sliding that up to a G7 flat 5 sus. So that's a G, D flat, F, and then another G. And then ending on a G flat 9. G flat again? It's not a G flat, is it? It's an A flat. Ah, okay. So we're starting on an A flat, a C, a G flat, and a B flat. Okay, so. And ending by landing on the D flat 7. So all together. Part of the song, we're just going between the 4 and the 1 of E flat again. Except this time we're going to be playing a lower voicing and no rhythm. So we're starting here on what is effectively a G flat. G flat, C, E flat. Playing that chord twice, and then we're going to an E flat 7. I'm playing that by playing this little voicing. As before, you can kind of play that anywhere. I just really like how it sounds. So we're playing a A flat, a D flat, and an E flat on top. Going to go to an F7. So all we're going to do is move this shape up one tone, playing a A, an E flat, and an F. Then we're going to end it all on the B flat augmented with the sharp 9. You can play the exact same thing as the first part, or you could play a B flat 7 sharp 9. It works, because they've both got sharp 9s. Or you can play it down here. So, I'm just going to play through it entirely one more time. Maybe I'll do it with the original. That's what I'll do. 1, 2, 3. The only final things I'd say, check out clips on YouTube. There's some incredible live performances of Higher Ground. There's one particular one of Stevie playing with Steve Gadd. And the guitarist for that one is just pretty much just playing. Watch the greats play the tune. It's a really, really good one to improve your funk chops with, I think. So hopefully this video wasn't too complex, but yeah, let me know what you think. I'll have sheet music in the description. Thanks again.